All right. 45 minutes of farming has left me with 10 Molotov cocktails. Let's see how Eileen the crow likes being set on fire 10 times. This is a horrible thing to do. But to be fair, she did kill me like probably 10 times also. Also, since I don't really know anything about her, maybe she's a bad person. Maybe I'm a bad person. Actually, I have been neglecting the possibilities of this rafters area, haven't I? Maybe I don't need to jump straight to the Molotovs. Please bear with me here. Hopefully it won't mean another death or two, you never know. Kill. Nope. Already taking too much damage. But what if I can get out here? Oh, she doesn't follow me that far. Oh, yes she does. I knew she did because I've fought her on the ground before. Yes! How much damage did that do? Oh ho ho! Hello. I'm up here. Ah, okay. Thought it might have been a little too easy. Where'd you go? This could be a problem, actually. I've actually completely lost track of her. See, what I was thinking was, now that she's fallen down there, I can just shoot at her, but it didn't work out that way. Well, I'm just going to use this in case Eileen's about to come out of nowhere and ambush me, which seems plausible. Where, in fact, is she? This is worrying. Because I... Oh, no, that's a ghost. Huh. I may have been over-clever here. I wonder if this game has plunging attack. Oh shit.
You still have dreams.
Oh my god! It's a freaking pylon! I mean, they're piling on me. It's not producing psi energy or control. Okay. So, fortunately, I wasn't carrying any number of blood monies that I care about recovering. What will be interesting is discovering whether Eileen is still down in that hole, which, I don't actually know the way down to. So, fun times are ahead. On the other hand, see, I believe she probably will still be down there because once before when I fought her, she ended up on the lower levels the next time. And if she is still down there, and there isn't a way up here from down there, well, maybe Plan Molotov is back on. Well, Plan Molotov is always back on no matter what. Like, my original plan here was to fight her normally in her own area, just, you know, using Molotovs to do tons of damage. Arf. Okay. This is indeed an interesting situation. Brought about, of course, solely by my own mistakes. It's the best kind of situation. I haven't fought one of these guys in a while, but I seem to remember... Yeah, they're tough, but the wood takes them out. Blood. Alright, everything looks quiet here on the mid-level. I would call it the upper level, but the rafters exist. There's a sniper over this way. I will not forget him. Ha! Ha! That's knowledge for you. That's the power of being a video game character. And here's something cool. That's where I died. So I can just grab this. Oh wait, that's actually where someone else died. Okay. I was thinking I would be able to grab my bloodstain, but it's not that simple. So down there is where I died, I guess. But, how far down? It was one of the rat things. Not sure if that tells me much. I do not see Eileen down there. Oh. No, they're just rats. Being caught down there seems like a very bad idea. Like, I can imagine going super wrong and just being surrounded by rats, basically, if things went in a bad direction. So I'll be careful around here. Tons of blood on these guys. It's like they have this stuff running through their veins. Come on, Eileen, something, something, something. I'm not Irish, so I don't know the words. Okay, I'm guessing she's back in her usual location. I'm not very confident about this, but I can test it easily enough. So let's think about Molotov cocktail damage. When I had her covered in oil, which increases the damage, it was like 140. So let's say that doubles it, it normally would only be 70. So my attacks were doing like 15 damage to her. Presumably she has a lot more physical resistance than fire resistance. Oh, that's where my blood was. Okay. Cool. So if I fell from here... Yeah, I don't see anyone down there. I should really go down and get all the treasure, but not right now. Hey. Okay, this is gonna be interesting. Oops.
You still have me.
Oh shit! And she got all the life back by hitting me. Oh, wow. I guess enemy hunters can do that. Did you see that? Like, she was literally using the same mechanism I have. Oh. Yikes. I don't know if this is going to work after all. Maybe I should return to the rafters plan. Gosh. By the way, just inside the house there, the old guy in the chair with the shotgun, or the blunderbuss, I think. He's a really good source of quicksilver bullets, reliably drops four of them, and the guy next to him sometimes drops some as well. So you get slightly more than four on average by taking a trip through that house. That is why I have 20 quicksilver bullets now. Woof, 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 arf, arf. Okay. So... I guess I do want your blood money. Can I rafter her? This way, please. see, by doing this, I might at least be able to stay in situations where... Wait, did she fall off again? Where did she go? Gosh. And it's kind of potentially good, but in practice kind of bad, mostly. I just lose track of her. She's wearing a black robe and a shadowed warehouse thing. I mean, so am I, but mine's not made of crew feathers, which are darker than midnight itself. Is that Eileen down there? Oh man. If I could aim. If I could just aim. If I was down there, I bet I could aim. Okay, let's get optimistic. Part of my optimism is the hope that she'll still be there, even though I've changed position. And also that none of these guys will interrupt me, so I'm gonna take steps. You know, killing one of them, so probably won't interrupt me. Oh! Dropped a bloodstone shard. That's cool, that means you can farm those. That's good news. Oh my god, she's still there! It's me, Silas Asshole, from a long line of assholes. I still have to not screw this up. I'm like trying not to celebrate here because while the situation is potentially in my favor at this point, I mean, she's really low health. If I can just get one more ranged hit on her, that's it. I still need to actually get that hit in, and she's moving around, and there's these dangerous guys, and I need to pick up whatever she drops. But still. This is clearly the place I want to be in. Compared to the past or whatever. Yes! 3,600 souls! I mean, blood money. Okay. Now, I need a way to get down there which lets me actually get back up. Because I want to pick up whatever she's dropped and truck it out of here. Gosh. This is kind of like kicking Knight Lautrec off the edge of Firelink Shrine, except that he deserved it. So it's quite different, really. Okay, Can I even see a door or anything down there? I could certainly jump, but that poses problems, like... how to get out again. But perhaps a professional wouldn't hesitate at this point. Yeah, once you've dealt with Eileen the Crow, there's no way a few rats pose any problems to you. Nice. So down there is where I want to be. There's more rats, that's okay. As long as they don't get any bigger than this. These rats are enormous, like... they must be beast rats, because a rat doesn't usually come in this size. Wow. I'm actually worried with the quantity of rats on the other side there. So, I think you can only get out down to these side areas by jumping. Okay, that's fine. And then the trench must have a way to walk out. I hope it doesn't just, like, kill you or something. So here's what I also hope. If I go down into that trench, will these rats get me? Like, what if all the rats jump down at that point? That would be ignominious. Madman's knowledge. If I'm about to die, I can at least die with the Crow Hunter badge. That makes sense. Let's stop a moment and have a look at the item description. No, I'm not going to stop a moment. I'd like to have a look at the item description, but not yet. Okay, so. I hear the clicking of the rat feet. All good so far. I've walked into the crow's den and I've come out... Well, no, that's the thing. I haven't come out alive because I haven't come out at all. But... Perhaps I will. Also, I've learned some more about how this area works, and I believe I'll be able to get that treasure safely in future. If I can find a way out here. Looks like... trap. It wasn't, I guess. These nozzles... It might be Sin's Fortress conditioning, but they make me nervous. I kind of... don't want to be standing between any two of them. Excellent. Okay, so I'm out of that trench and now I'm who knows the fuck where. That's cool. That's really cool. I hear noises, footsteps. Look, as long as there's no basilisks here. What was that? Might be on edge. God, my footsteps are so loud in this sewer. What? I hear somebody. Someone's shooting at me. But the good news is they can't hit me. Okay, fuck! Okay, so. I would not have survived that, except that I've begun developing the right instincts for Bloodborne. This is not Dark Souls. If someone jumps out of nowhere and hits you, you have to attack back. That is the only chance of survival, because you need those hit points back. You can't Estus. Snipers. Oh, I know where this place is. Oh, it's a ladder, but they'll shoot me off of it, or will they? Shit. Yes! I made it back. Okay! Now, I could capitalize on having killed... I'm going home. Not capitalizing on anything. Oh man, have I got any cold blood on me? No, but yeah, whatever. Used to gain insight. That's cool. Ah, yes, so... A madman touched by the wisdom of the Great Ones. A grander purpose for posterity. And is linked by the resonance of bells to incorporation. What is this Sword Hunter badge? Oh, this must be what gave me new items at the marksman, the messenger shop. The old hunters who have long passed from the dream but cannot forget the feeling of the hunt rely on messengers to relay their thoughts. That's interesting. A hunter's dead and the dream is a kind of purgatory? I don't know. Night of the hunt is long and unchanging. That's night connected to other nights. Badge of a hunter of hunters who hunts those who have become addled with blood. That's why she called me a drunk. Quietly passed down from generation to generation. Usually to an outsider from the hinterlands. Like me, for example, a foreign professional. To be entrusted with this cursed badge, one must be strong, resilient to the seduction of blood, and gracious when taking a comrade's life. I don't know if I'd say I was gracious exactly. Not in as many words. Dogs. Dogs everywhere. So, here is like the first thing which has irked me about Bloodborne level design. In general, it's a big improvement on Dark Souls. Oh dear. Overall, design-wise, the game is a big improvement on Dark Souls 2. Like, much more wanny. But because there is this intermediate realm, this Hunter's Dream, it means that I cannot spend souls. I mean, blood echoes. Unless I return to the dream, which will reset the whole area. So, if I wanted to, like, preserve the, I guess, progress that I've made in, the sewer area. I was close to an interconnection there, I think. But, it doesn't matter, because the sewer area's progress is now kind of denied to me. Hey, you can go through here. That's handy. I'll just head to the bullet shop while I'm here. See? So let me just actually finish that thought. What I wanted to say was, if I go back to the Hunter's Dream to spend blood echoes, as I'm about to do, it will reset my progress, meaning that I will no longer have kind of killed some guys in that area. It's just slightly a shame that you can't just walk up to a real world area, unless this guy is willing to buy and sell stuff.
Yes, I see. But the Great Bridge is the only way to the Cathedral Ward. And during the hunt, the bridge is closed. You could try the aqueduct.
Oh.
There's a rather, how shall I put it, colorful area south of the Great Bridge. From there, an aqueduct leads to the Cathedral Ward. Not a place you'd normally want to visit, but I don't imagine you have much of a choice.
That's interesting. Now, I have successfully crossed the Great Bridge, but he doesn't know that. So the aqueduct area is leads in the same direction, does it? Yeah. Unless I'm going to find out the bridge actually is closed. Well, I'll find that out shortly. Possibly. Now, putting some pieces together here. I haven't actually checked whether you can progress beyond the Great Bridge. I'm now guessing, or maybe you can't. However, when I killed the Cleric Beast at the end of the bridge, I got a Sword Hunter badge. And that badge seems to have caused the messengers to sell me more things. One of which was a key. So possibly, if I was to buy this key, a key to the gate to the Grand Cathedral's Round Plaza, perhaps that would let me take the aqueduct route. I'll go and explore some more and test these theories out. And does the Crow Hunter badge also unlock items for sale? Blade of Mercy. Oh, that's expensive. That. How can I display my current stuff? Special trick weapon passed down among hunters of hunters, one of the oldest weapons in the workshop. Oh, it's the double attack thing that Eileen was making. Ooh. I would like that. I think that would be appropriate for my build too. Cool. If I had 40,000 blood echoes, which I definitely do not have. You may recall I said I farmed for 45 minutes to buy Molotov cocktails. As Molotov cocktails aren't that expensive. 10 of them is 1,800 echoes. Repeating pistol. Mmm. A whole set of crew gear. Wow. Wood-carved mask of Eileen the Crow, Hunter of Hunters. Contains incense to mask scents of blood and beast. The first Hunter of Hunters came from a foreign land. Find rest in a hunter's dream. Crow feather garb. This is some cool stuff, and I'm really sorry about the appalling murder that I did to get it. So I can't afford any of that stuff right now. I will look forward to having it later. Where is the doll? Why is the doll gone? You can like... Okay, so why are you sometimes a doll and then sometimes you're like walking around and stuff?
Welcome home, good hunter. What is it you desire?
An explanation?
Ah, they speak.
But I'll settle for a level up.
Very well, let me step.
Can afford 1 point here. I'm tempted to put a point in vitality, more hit points would be nice. But I'm also tempted to just continue ignoring it and go for like a pure skill-based, super cool build, which I do not have the IRL skill to back up. Maybe I'll force myself to like learn to play, and I assure you when I say learn to play that I'm spelling it L-E-R-N, the number 2, P-L-A-Y.
Farewell, good hunt.
Yeah, farewell to you also. Yes, fortify that. Looking good. I might look at the stats screen for the first time ever. Never actually opened this before. Right hand weapon 1 attack 115. It's considerably higher than it once was. Oh, my discovery points are 100. My beasthood is 407. I don't really know the implications of those things, however. Anyway, Eileen's dead, I'm alive, this may or may not be a desirable state of affairs, but let's be professional about it and just continue the journey. So, as the sick man, who I believe was called... He was not called Geralt. Geralt of Rivia is the Witcher. He was called... I do not know what he was called. Anyway, he was a nice guy. Unfortunately, probably dying. And he seemed to think I would not be able to progress beyond the end of the Great Bridge. I haven't actually checked here. I kind of assumed I would be able to, but... Indeed, I cannot open this gate. And indeed, I cannot open this door. So, the aqueduct which I've been exploring is actually the next place to go. Alright. And let's go there. Oh man. Just kind of thinking about... I don't know how much kind of... effect turning one character hostile will have on this game. It could vary, but like other From Software games, it's going to be massively dependent on which character. And in some cases, it just won't matter. losing a bunch of story or something, and then in other cases it's kind of a thing you can optionally do and you're changing the story and it can be a good thing. It's, well, varied. Alright, to the aqueduct. How many people are there up here? Right, there's three of them total up here. Well, two in the room, one on the stairs. Then down here there's one more standing guy. And the chairman. Ooh, ow. Wow. Made a mistake there. It wasn't ultimately consequential. So, this aqueduct entrance is the dog entrance, where there's also a woman who wants safety. The other one is past the two wolves, who I can kill, but it's not exactly like I have them on farm, and so I will generally avoid engaging them. Still, getting to that entrance wouldn't be too difficult, and I would like to find the path that connects them up. I was in there before. So you head through this warehouse, I guess, let's call it a warehouse, and beyond it was that same sewer area that I'd been into once before, descending a ladder. I see that weapon upgrades are a big deal in this game. I couldn't kill these guys in four hits before. Still can't kill that one in four hits. But I was very close to it, like another point or two of skill or another upgrade and I would do it. I'm glad this is a game where you can trust it to... If you stand here and there's a guy pointing a gun at the wall, the bullet will not just go through it and hit you. You really feel, and if you like walk on apparently walkable area, you won't fall off, even though you can totally just step off the edge. The game challenges you to do very difficult things, but it really rewards your trust in it by being consistent. Now let's, oh. Wrong side. Oh. On both sides. Did I not pick this one up before? Wow. That could have been done slightly better. Oh. Right. It's the guy I knocked down here. I really should have descended the other side, where there is an actual treasure to pick up, as opposed to just a dead body. Well, I can go around and come up the ladder, but there is a problem associated with that. Snipers. This is going to be interesting. So I want to explore this area while feeling less terrified, even though I've still got 3,000 blood money on me. So I should still be scared, but it's not so new to me anymore. And I just, I guess, feel like I am in some sense doing better now. Something behind me? That's the shadow of the ladder. Nothing in here. If I proceed in that direction, I'm likely to go somewhere else entirely. This ladder might be the only way up. I was able to trick one of them earlier into jumping down and trying to get me. Well, I say trick. That guy didn't have a gun, so he may well have been justified. I'm pretty sure that further up there on that upper level is the connector, so I do want to explore back up to there. Maybe I better bite the bullet or get shot by the bullet. Where does this lead? Oh, hang on, what's... No, don't hang on, stop hanging on. There's ladders everywhere all of a sudden. I don't know if I really want to go down there. There's a treasure, but it also looks kind of... spikes on that thing. Yeah, I'm going up rather than down to start with, just in case something horrible happens. Ooh. Crows on a rail. Hey, look, it's... Is it a part of the city I've been in? I don't actually think so, no. It's just the upper part of the aqueduct. Where's this going? Huh. There's a song that has the line "Whip it real good" in it, and keeps coming to my head. I may have to make it a soundtrack at some point. This is manifold. It's another ladder. It's also a brick man who I can probably just kill. But who does? I'm not trying to fool you. Ma'am, I am a professional. I will not hurt you. I don't even particularly want to enter your house, although it would be nice to have a respite. Oh, shit. That guy doesn't just have a brick, so I'm really good I stuck the parry. Really glad I stuck the parry, because, he looked more dangerous than the others in retrospect. ladders all over the place. Oh ho! Could it be the shortest and sweetest of cuts? Oh, it was this area. Oh, that's not particularly great. There's no real reason to be here. Still, that's cool, I guess. Well... no, I guess it does provide an alternative route to the sewers, because you can run down the road, ignore everyone, keep running, run, and probably get all the way up here without much hassle. Cool, I guess. I could use it to return, but I could also just do that this other way. Well, probably. There's a ladder. This didn't go anywhere, did it? No, it was just a treasure there. Now, what would be really nice if I could get from this ladder onto that platform, but I don't think I can do that. So, to really explore the rest of the sewers, I am going to have to take the shootable ladder up. I hope I don't just die doing this. It seems a bit random. For example, I could just not take any damage. That's a possible outcome. Huh. I'm not complaining, just... it seems unreliable, essentially. Hello? Hello. Oops. He can fall off if he wants to, I'm not going to. I wonder if it'll climb the ladder. Cold blood dew. Nice. I'm really starting to get the hang of the layout of Central Yharnam, which is so massively interconnected that holy shit, it's like, I don't know, it feels like they're probably either breaking or obeying some sort of law. This is the same ladder, yes? Okay. But this aqueduct cannot actually go where I think it does. It's in the wrong direction for that. Yeah, this doesn't connect with the very first aqueduct entrance I found, actually. Not this area. Hmm. That must connect with something else. I will have to return to that path separately at some point. Now, I'm almost done with the warehouses, but I'm not actually. Take a step forward. Alright. That's quite enough steps forward. Almost done with the warehouses. Not actually done with the warehouses because there was one more treasure I can pick up by jumping down from them. I like the whip. I feel like I should be able to open more of these boxes and barrels and stuff, but I'll settle for blowing them to pieces. Nice. Bloodstone shard. And this ladder is now perfectly safe. I'm about to have to fight some rats, so I do want to heal up. It's amazing how much less daunting the whole area seems now that it doesn't have an aggravated hunter of hunters inside it. Okay. Rats off to you. There it is, the saw spear. Whatever the heck that is. And this area is fully explored. I seriously do not know what a saw spear is. Let's check it out. It's not a weapon, is it? It is. Oh, it's a new weapon. Very bad scaling, mind you, but reasonable base damage, particularly since it's not upgraded. Good durability. What is it doing stuff? It's a saw. It's a saw that turns into a spear. Okay. I will have to try that out at some point soon. Not, I think, while exploring a new area, unless I, you know, run into some sort of dire straits and find myself needing to mix things up. So, the aqueduct continues, at least this part of it does. I do believe there is another entrance, which... Could that be it up there? Could that be the other aqueduct entrance? I may have gone around in the right direction for that to be the case. So, let's take this slightly ominous ladder downward. Into... place with some fairly horrific looking things in it, like that guy in a Australian hat. Yikes. What do they do? Whatever they do, I'd prefer not to find out. What? Heard a noise. Oh, it's crows. Yeah. We'll leave those alone for now. Alright, so let's go to the obvious trap here. Like, seriously, what is going... There it is. I wondered what was going to attack me. Oh! The whole thing is a pile of those moving body guys. Okay. Wow. It's a good thing I'm not oblivious to standard video game conventions. Bold Hunter's Mark. That's a good thing to have. Oh, that's a very good thing to have where I am. Here's what it actually is. I saw one of these in the shop. Well, I mean, the basin, I guess. The normal Hunter's Mark, which you have at all times, can be consumed to eat up all of your blood money, but also teleport you back to the Hunter's Dream, or to at least the Lantern. The Bold Hunter's Mark does that without costing echoes. I'm sure it's a consumable, but it's also... consumable otherwise. It is a way to go home, to get out of jail-free card, or get out of dungeon-free. Town portal, if you will. Well, not quite a town portal, you still have to make your way back to wherever you are. And might I just say, I'm feeling so much better about Bloodborne level design and DS2 level design on that basis, of having to go around the place and navigate and find my way around things. The whole thing has been basically a Yharnam is kind of just a huge version of the Undead Burg, which is cool. It doesn't have Dark Souls 2's variety and colour, and it doesn't have, I had figured out how to break that game open, it just became easy for me. It was a bit easy in a fun way, because I was like having to execute skill-based challenges, but regularly succeeding at them. And this is like a new system, and I'm not very good at it yet. But that's fine, it's like the challenge thing. Like, I have good feelings about this game. This feels like, well, you know, I just kind of don't like sequels also. And this feels like, in many ways, a better successor to Dark Souls than DS2 was. I mean, I'm still looking forward to Dark Souls 3 separately, but... I'm very happy to have had the opportunity to play Bloodborne. Another letter. Okay, this reminds me of the spike pig. I don't want to go down there yet. Oh shit, that looks bad. That looks like a boss fight waiting to happen. It looks like something would charge along the sewers and crush me underfoot. I don't know. It seems like something I might not like. Aha! I'm in a very good place to be. I recognize this. I'm on the other side of this thing. Yes. Oh. Although... Where's this go? Oh, it's the Cathedral Ward. I've made it. It's like a group of guys waiting for me. Probably not friendly. I'm going to try a thing. This is more or less what I was hoping would happen. Yep. I thought I recognized it. Now I can go down as well, and I bet the levers work now. Okay. That's a really good shortcut to have. Right. down for another trip to the dream, I think. Oh, I parried him, but... I've mentioned this before, the problem with parrying certain attacks is it doesn't actually prevent them from hurting you. I wouldn't even stop for old man bullets today. Stop the himbo. Alright, and I'm back in Central Yharnam. I mean, I'm back at the Central Yharnam lab. Okay, so that seems like a good amount of progress. Next time I play, I look forward to interacting with at least one of the following three things. The bridge to the Cathedral Ward, at least I think it was the Cathedral Ward, on which some sort of mob is waiting for me. The pig in the tunnels. I don't know if I look forward to that, but I'm going to do it. And the alternate aqueduct entrance. I will also want to explore that. For now, I'll just shut up the doll.
Welcome home. What is it you... Very well, let me...
Someone's going to have to tell me what the soft caps for stats are in this iteration of the system, because until I know otherwise, I'm probably going to keep putting points in skill here. I may well be causing myself problems, but it increases the damage of my weapon. It's hard to argue with that.
Farewell, good. May you find your worth in the waking world.
I'll settle for finding out what's going on in this city.